Hello and welcome to International Women's Day. I am Dr. Theresa Phillips, broadcasting here from Chicago, and I'm going to talk to you about women's empowerment today. We are getting ready to have our Summit for Destiny Arising, May 2nd through the 4th, but this is Women's Day. This is International Women's Day, and I just want to give honor to some of the women that have gone on before us to prepare the way in so many ways. Who can they be? Who can some of these women be that have really changed and transformed the world? What about Susan B. Anthony, whose roots were deep in activism and social justice? We have so many women today that are fighting for social justice, and we need to have that because that's the government mountain. We need to go with that government mountain. You have Dr. Elizabeth Blackwell was the first woman to receive a medical degree from medical school. And I want to say that is the education mountain. This woman, these women that I'm going to bring to you today are some women that have really transformed lives in so many ways. My favorite is Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa was originally from Macedonia, and she ended up in India. And one of her statements that she made was that if I hadn't picked up the first one, I would never have picked up the thousands after. Now, I want to address something about another situation with Mother Teresa that was pivotal in my life when I read her book. She said she had a call within the call. Now, I was just perked up when I heard that because the call within the call is that it's typically women. We are multifaceted. But while she was a nun cloistered behind the walls, she had been given permission to go outside the walls, and she saw the tragedy and the travesty of the human life in India, and she wanted to make a difference. And she thought loving the people would make a difference. So even though she was a nun and she was cloistered behind the walls, she ended up actually developing the Sisters of Mercy, the missionaries, and she ended up being a Mother Superior in her own right. But yet she never gave up the fact that she was a nun, and yet within that call, she became a world-renowned figure. We also know the story of Anne Frank. Anne Frank was the young girl that was behind the, you know, behind the hidden wall for a long time during World War II, and then her family was turned in, and she died during World War II. But her story is absolutely phenomenal, and to this day, people talk about Anne Frank. One of the other women that I thought is phenomenal is Golda Meir. Golda Meir, the first woman prime minister of Israel. She was an amazing woman. We had the prime minister of Margaret Thatcher, an amazing woman in England. We have had a woman running for president in the United States. I'm telling you, these are people that are making inroads, and they are making changes in the lives of other people. And these women are powerful women. Now, we know that there's going to be people that are going to be overbearing. We know these things. But when we look at the opportunities that are being given women today, with many of the movements that are out there today, we are beginning to recognize that the voices that we thought were silenced are beginning to be heard. And I want to just share a little bit of my story. 30 years ago, I started a church. 30 years ago, women didn't do what I was doing. And I remember my grandmother and my father saying, "You've got a hard road to hoe. You've got a very hard road to hoe." And I remember my father saying, "I don't know how you're ever going to be able to do what you think you're called to do." And I said, "Well, I just have to because God told me to do it." And it was just a matter of yes. And he told me, he said, "I really hope that you make it and that you stay true to your call." Well, my grandmother had come to me and she said, "I don't know what you're doing, but you're a throwback to the old." And I was like, what did that mean? And it meant that she came from a denomination where there were women that were operating in the gospel, that they were doing things. And she said, "I was a throwback. I was a throwback. And at first I thought she meant that I was a throwaway, but it took a long time before I realized what that word throwback really meant. And because of these women that have been in my life, my strong mother who was a newspaper reporter, and yet she was a mother of five and watched two of her sons die, and the things that she went through in her life, when she found out she was pregnant with myself and my twin brother, she didn't think mentally she could handle twins. So she had actually lobbied her doctors in order to try to have an abortion. And they finally admitted that she should have an abortion because they didn't think she was mentally capable of having children. Well, she ended up walking into a church one day, got on her knees, and said the Lord's Prayer. And it was from that moment my life was spared. I was going to be a victim of abortion. Instead, I became alive and able to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ around the world and now raise up a company of women who are a mighty throng that are willing to take the seven cultural spheres of influence: business, education, family, faith, government, arts and entertainment, and media. I love the fact that I am the president and founder, CEO, whatever you want to call it, of Destiny Arising, an international movement that now has women from 15 nations involved with it, and we have five chapters. We are growing, and we are excited about growing. May 2nd through the 4th in St. Charles, Illinois, at the Hilton Garden Inn, we will be having our fourth international summit. Our fourth international summit. And we are excited about that. And it's not for women only. We have a lot of men that are members of Destiny Arising. This year, we have David Yarns coming in. He is what I call the Seven Mountain Pastor of Morningstar. And I can't wait for him to come in. And he is coming in. He's going to sit down. He's going to communicate. He's going to talk with our guests that are there. And I'm not talking about the guest speakers. I'm talking about you. You're going to have access to the speakers. You're going to be able to ask questions. You're going to be able to get some information. You're going to walk out the door with outlines of everybody's message, so that you can start your own understanding of the Seven Mountain Mandate. The Seven Mountains are the seven cultural spheres of influence that have always been predominantly occupied by men. But the truth be told, they're actually occupied by an Antichrist spirit. And it's going to take the church to come together, and it's going to take men and women to come together that care about one another and care about one thing and one thing only: the success and well-being of others. Even God loves us to advance His kingdom, and to advance His kingdom, we have to move into the seven spheres of influence. And I'm going to say, it is the faith movement. We need faith to arise in a mighty way. Our faith has stumbled. And we have been curtailed, but our faith must arise. Number two, our families are important to us. We must remember that we are a living epistle and for our families. So the family mountain is vital. Family mountain also means community. No man can do it alone. We all need one another. Then we have the education mountain. We need to train and equip others to succeed and to fulfill their dreams and their opportunities that come their way. We don't want to let opportunities slip through our fingers. We really want to be able to recognize when an opportunity is before us and have the courage to step through that door and take that sphere of influence that God has given us. And yes, we're going to make mistakes. Yes, we're going to fall. Yes, that is going to happen. But our yes to the call, whatever it may be, is going to far outweigh the mistakes that we make, because all He's looking for is a faithful vessel. Then you have the government mountain. We are beginning to see more people of faith operate in the government mountain. Even our president has had more people of faith, of different denominations of faith, come in and pray over him and speak into his life. This is very important, because that is the structure upon which foundations of morality are released. We need that structure of faith. We need that balance of faith so that we know what we believe in, because when we know what we believe in, we know who we are. Otherwise, we have identity challenges, and then we have chaos in identity, as we see so much throughout the world today. Then you have the arts and entertainment mountain. This is a mountain that's very influential right now. Activists from arts and entertainment are stating their political views everywhere, but the church is actually arising, and we have a lot of people like Akiana. We have people in Destiny Arising that are artists, that are dancers, that are movie makers, that are producers. They are in part of Destiny Arising, and they are changing atmospheres through arts and entertainment. We have politicians that are involved with Destiny Arising. We have ministers that are involved with Destiny Arising. We have homemakers that are involved with Destiny Arising. We have entrepreneurs. This year's focus is going to be primarily on the fact that you are an entrepreneur in every sphere of influence. Sometimes you don't even realize it. We have a lady in our church that developed a book, and she made it out of fabric, and it was a wonderful, wonderful children's book. That book is going to become her cash cow. So we're trying to encourage her to find a way to get that book published. She made it out of fabric, and it has every part of the Nativity in it. Noah's Ark, it's got everything in it. It's a fabulous story. And yet this is a tool in order to teach children the gospel of Jesus Christ. I honor that in her because it's a gift and she is able to do that. We also have people in Destiny Arising that are running for political office. And some of them are even going to be there at the summit, and you will hear their journey. You'll hear their story, and you'll hear why they're running for office. We're going to have people that are coming into the summit that may not even know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, but they're coming in because they have something to impart and they have something to receive. And then we have the Media Mountain, which is what we're on right now. We're in the Media Mountain because I am recording this recording. It is going out today on International Women's Day to encourage you women that you are in all seven cultural spheres of influence. If you read a book, if you're on the phone, if you're on the internet, you're there. You're in the Media Mountain. And then we have the Business Mountain. Now, I know that there's a lot of people that are going to be at the summit that have business, have a desire for a business, or hope to have a business, or have a dream about a business. And that business also means to be about the master's business. We are always about the Father's business in all seven cultural spheres of influence without getting up and preaching a sermon. We are presenting who we are to the public so that they know that there is a group of women that are willing to stand by you and stand by your dreams and help you make that come to pass. I was a child, and my sister wanted to be an airline stewardess. I thought that would just be fantastic to be in that, but I'm only 5 foot nothing. I mean, I am 5 foot nothing. And I thought, oh, I want to be a fashion model. I want to be a model. That dream, I went to modeling school, and I went to finishing school. And that was my introduction to how to style clothing, how to style hair, how to style makeup. How to use protocol. Protocol is very important. My father was basically a protocol specialist, and so he taught me a lot. On the way to school in the morning, we would have great conversations, and he taught me a lot. And I ended up writing a book called Honor, A Blueprint to Kingdom Conduct, and that's on Global Prophetic Voice if you're interested. But I had a desire as a child to be a model. There's no way they were going to make me a model. Now we have petite models. But at that time, you had to be like 5'8", 5'9", to be a model. And you had to look a certain way. You had to be a certain way to be a model. And now, all these years later, God has given me a business called Redeem and Renew Skin Solutions. And I developed a skincare line, and I'm my face. And I actually love what I'm doing with this, because not only did it transform me, not only did it transform my skin and the way I looked, but something happened to me on the inside. I realized that a dream that I had as a child came to pass a different way And I am totally fulfilled in that dream. I had a desire to be a model, and now I'm the face at this moment for my skincare company. So I am modeling that out, and I'm modeling out the kingdom. I am modeling out the desires of others. I am modeling it out in front of people. And I hope to be a good role model to those that are coming up and have desires and passion. That is why we started Destiny Arising. And this was to see women fulfill their passions and desires in all the 7 cultural spheres of influence. So I'm a family member. I am a pastor, so I have a church family. I have a blood family. I have a community that I'm involved in. I have charity work that I am involved with Be a Hero to a Hero. That's family. I work closely with our veterans and we're doing things like that. And then I'm on social media, which is, you know, it couples with arts and entertainment and media. All of that is kind of like grouping together. It's like merging. It's like every time we do a video, we're doing a production of some sort. So we're in that. I'm in the faith mountain because I'm a pastor and I have faith. I have faith to see you succeed. I have faith to succeed where I never thought I could succeed because I found out my identity. And I found that my identity was in the kingdom of God. I'm telling you my journey, your story is your story. But this is my story. I'm in the government mountain because the government mountain is also slash military. And my husband is 30 years in the United States Air Force. And because of that, I'm now the chaplain of the Women's Auxiliary and Sergeant at Arms of the Women's Auxiliary of the American Legion. So I am in that sphere of the government mountain, as well as written a book and sent the book Ambassador's Prayer Guide to every senator, congressman, and governor in the United States. So those are my, and I've opened the Senate in prayer. So those are just my stories of what I have been involved with in the government mountain. I was just with an alderwoman today, and this alderwoman is going to be at Destiny Arising, bringing a proclamation from the mayor of our community, welcoming us to the community because it's an international summit. So as you look and see, I'm in the 7 cultural spheres of influence, and you can identify that you are as well. I'm a teacher. I have online schooling. That puts me in the education mountain. Do you see? All of us are doing something in these 7 cultural spheres of influence. And today, being International Women's Day, I want to encourage you to go to destinyarising.net and register for the upcoming summit. You will receive materials. You'll receive contact, interaction with the 12 speakers that are going to be speaking. You will be given an impartation on how to build an atmosphere for success. How do you do that? You're going to hear about media, how to use the social media for your advantage, for you to grow your sphere of influence. You're going to hear from people who are in the government mountain. Perhaps you've been called to that, and you need to know a little bit more about that. And you're a homemaker. How do you juggle these things and be a homemaker? We're going to help give you the tools to make you feel like that in every sphere of influence that you're in, that you feel that you are accomplished and that you're not less than, that you're part of. Also, we have producers that are going to be there. People who are in filmmaking are going to be presenting. As a matter of fact, we have one of the executive members of our board is in the process right now of making a documentary film, and they're going to be presenting that at the summit. I think there's going to be a trailer to that film coming out at the summit. Politicians, businesswomen, businessmen, ministers, homemakers, lovers of humanity, charity workers, people that are reaching out and touching others and making a change in their lives. I don't want you to miss it. Go to destinyarising.net today and register for this outstanding, epic summit. We have Stevie Knight coming in. She is the Seven Mountain Media Guru. She is coming in. I'm going to be speaking. We have Joy Van Patten, who is a government official. She will be speaking. Paulette Horvath is going to be talking about team building. Barbara Velez is our hot-blooded Puerto Rican, and she is going to be talking about the me mountain, how we take care of us, our own, how do we make it for ourselves. She has got a great message on that me mountain. And all of this is all-inclusive as to be one. Destiny Arising, an international summit for women and men who want to build and succeed in all seven cultural spheres of influence. Go to destinyarising.net right now and register for the summit. God bless, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.